chain of five missions established along the San Antonio River in the 18th century became the largest concentration of Catholic missions in North America. Four of the missions, the San Jose, the San Juan, the Concepcion, and the Espada, were originally founded in East Texas. The missions flourished during the middle of the 18th century, but later declined due to inactivity. I am Sean Stauffer, and we are on location at the Linda Watson Gallery for the silent auction entitled Missions, featuring the beautiful oil paintings of John Porter's Texas Missions. Tonight is the conclusion of the showing, and all the proceeds will be going to the Conroe Salvation Army. Also tonight is a reception for all the artists that participated in this showing. So let's go meet the artists, let's look at some of their paintings, and maybe we can learn a little bit about the beautiful missions of the United States in our great state of Texas. I'm with John Porter, the artist featured tonight here at the gallery. I'm wondering, John, you were encouraged by a special friend to do this. Could you tell us about that?
Well, Craig Campabella, who is a local sculptor doing the flag part, the Texian, he encouraged me to do the missions. I was going to do the Alamo. He said, well, the Alamo is overworked. Go ahead and do Goliad. So I started with Goliad in around April. And I completed eight of them. And cornerstone framing with Carrie Smith, who did the framing for me, did an excellent job. This is kind of unique style of framing we've done. And I decided to give all the proceeds that all of these paintings tonight to the Salvation Army, which I have a very soft spot for the homeless. And it's just something I've always done. I just have a very deep feeling for them.
Why do you think it's important for the citizens of Conroe and Montgomery County to be involved in giving back to the community in this way?
Well, the homeless people, by circumstances, you know, we don't know. Maybe they turned their back on society, but as a society, we don't have to turn our backs on them. So my feelings is that it's pay forward. And that's what I'm doing here, and I hope we can raise enough money that all the proceeds will go directly to the Salvation.
I'm with Jerry Vineyard. Jerry is one of the artists featured here at the gallery tonight. Jerry, what was your inspiration?
Well, my father-in-law is John Porter, and I live in Crockett, and I was an art teacher here and an artist here in Conroe for a very long time, so I've been blessed enough to be able to come back and put artwork in the gallery, and the theme was mission, so I chose San Jose. And that's why I painted the picture for tonight's event.
What do you think giving back to the community like this means to everybody?
Well, I believe that what John's doing here is a wonderful thing. I'm a pastor in Crockett, and any time that we can give back to people and help those who are in need, I think is a wonderful thing. And being able to use your talents as an artist to do that, I think, is key.
God's gift, certainly. And I love your painting. I have to tell you, it's one of my favorites.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Okay, thank you.
I'm with Dave Mahavier. Dave is one of the artists featured at tonight's showing. Dave, tell us about your two fabulous paintings behind us.
Okay, thank you. This is San Elizario Mission. I did it in watercolor. And this is a model of the mission that one of my friends made for me. This one is the Chapel de San Fernando. It's the John Wayne Alamo movie set. And I painted this a number of years ago. It's all watercolor also.
I'm with Rosemary Massey. Rosemary is one of the featured artists tonight. Rosemary, tell me about the inspiration behind your paintings.
Well, in these two paintings, these are from Antigua, Guatemala. And my husband's a missionary, and we travel down there. We've traveled to Mexico. And when I see something that is beautiful, I would like to paint it. And so I've taken a lot of photographs, and these are the ones that are two of them that have come from Guatemala.
Are these oil or are these watercolor or mixed media?
They're watercolor.
Absolutely fabulous. And why do you think it's important for the citizens of Conroe and Montgomery County to become involved in raising money for the Salvation Army and the community as a whole?
Oh my goodness, they do so much for the community. And I think that it is very important that we as Americans, whether we're in Tampa, Conroe, or anywhere, that we need to support the ministries that service the people in our community.
I absolutely could not agree more. These paintings are absolutely fabulous. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
I'm with Ethan Rushing, and Ethan is the grandson of John Porter. Ethan, tell us a little bit about your beautiful paintings here behind us.
This was my first one. I painted it because I wanted to be like my grandpa.
Very, very beautiful work. Thank you so much, Ethan, for being with us.
Thank you.
I'm with Olivia Vineyard, and Olivia is the granddaughter of artist John Porter. Olivia, tell us about your beautiful painting here.
Well, right now, in the picture, they're getting ready to go to battle, and
they're going to battle. It's wonderful. And what is this in the background, this building?
The Alamo.
And is this an oil painting?
It is acrylic painting.
Acrylic paint. Olivia, thank you so much for being with us. You're a wonderful artist.
Thank you.
I'm with Joe and Jean Fleshner. They are the owners of the Linda Watson Gallery. Tell on location, how did you become involved with this, and what inspired you to become involved in the community?
Well, we had an art gallery in Old Town Spring for 3 years, and then my husband came out to Conroe and had his architectural practice upstairs in the Madeley building, and that went very well. But then this space, which had been a used bookstore, became available, and he decided to rent this, renovate it, and make it available to local artists.
And why do you think it's important for the community to become involved in causes such as the Salvation Army?
John Porter is a very giving guy. He feeds the homeless as they walk by out here, and he says it's time that he pays back what God has given him. So the gallery decided to do a show for John on the San Antonio Missions. He's donating all the proceeds plus my money. And to date, we've got a little over $1,200 for the Salvation Army. We're not done yet.
Wonderful. Tell everybody where your gallery is located, the address.
We're at 204 North Main Street, almost at the corner of Metcalf.
And it's the Linda Watson Gallery.
The Linda Watson Gallery. This gallery was named in her honor. She was a local artist and a teacher at both Magnolia and Conroe High School. Her whole emphasis was mentoring young people and getting their art out there. And we lost her to cancer and just felt this was a good way to honor her memory.
It's a wonderful way to honor someone's memory. Thank you so much for being with us. On the behalf of everyone in Conroe, thank you for giving back to the community like this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We're wrapping things up at the Linda Watson Gallery. Lots of beautiful paintings and lots of money raised for the Salvation Army. Remember, if you'd like us to highlight your special event, email us at onlocationmontgomery@yahoo.com. I'm Sean Stoffer, and we'll see you on location.